Celebrate Jesus.
Haven Hope Church, a true Pentecostal church with outward and upward praise and worship of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, in the covenant fulfillments of the prophecies of the scriptures, the seed of humanity, in need and without hope, will flood our church. As God has promised in a word to us, if you remain faithful to me, I will remain faithful to you. With that promise in mind and the word that God has given us, we now know that Jesus Christ, through His church, has become the haven of hope for the hopeless. Haven of Hope Church, bringing hope to the hopeless in a hopeless world. Your hope is here. His name is Jesus.
Well, I want to praise the Lord for, you know, the message this morning. It was a purpose to serve for correction, and some of us needed it this morning. So.
Amen.
I'm praising the Lord for that. Amen.
Well, I'm glad y'all feel so good. I'll tell you what, I was nervous about that one.
Brother Mason, I want to agree with you. Yeah. It takes a strong pastor to be led by the Lord and lead his sheep.
Yes.
You know, and it takes that sheep to receive it. You know,
Amen.
We're not disobedient, but we're here with an open ear. And I thank God for my pastor. Because a lot of pastors is just living in this society now, saying close the doors. You know, but I read a book, and the book said, forsake not your sibling gathering together.
Amen.
That's what the book said.
Amen.
So I thank God for that word this morning. That word and the word that Brother get, feed me, brother. Bring it on.
Amen. Amen. Somebody praise the Lord.
Amen.
Let's read Psalms 133 and 1 together, shall we? It says, behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. Amen. We're going to enter his courts, well, I mean his gates with what?
Thanksgiving!
And his courts with what?
Praise!
That is a challenge offered here around here. You, once you're driving into this parking lot, you start thanking him for everything he's done for you in your life, this week, and this month, whatever the case. And when you're walking through these doors, you need to start praising his name for all those things that he's done for you.
Amen. Amen.
We have a tent revival camp meeting coming up on August 2nd, going through the 8th. We have evangelist Donnie Raven coming to preach for us, so please invite everyone out. There's going to be a giant tent out here. And we're going to have people, you know, you can either pull up or you can bring in a lawn chair, whatever you need to do to get comfortable and hear the word of God.
Brother Mason, that thing is just going to be all kinds of accessible. You can come and sit in the chairs under the tent. They will be socially distanced. Well, you can bring your own lounge chair and sit outside the tent. The walls won't be on the side of the tent, so the air can circulate through. You'll be protected that way. You can drive up and sit in your car and pay it. Or you can log into the live stream. We're going to fix it where you can see this service.
Amen.
And not only that, we've got every night will be filled with special guest singers. And I can't remember which night, but Sister Sam Tyler, or Sam?
Sam Tyler.
Sam Martin Dunn.
Sam Martin.
Well, Tyler's her husband's name.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's Sunday night. Sam Martin Dunn is going to be here, and she's going to be our special singer.
Hallelujah.
And Robin Etheridge is going to be here, I think, on that Saturday night. Praise God.
Hallelujah. At this time, I just ask that if you have any special requests for prayer and any spoken requests, make us known by uplifted hand. Amen. If you want to share those right now, you can do so at this time.
Yeah, I have one. My wife failed yesterday. Actually, it was Friday. I'm sorry. She fell Friday and fractured her arm.
Oh.
And I told me in prayer that when she goes back to the doctor, she doesn't have to have surgery.
Amen.
He'll heal her arm without having to go through surgery.
Amen.
Anyone else? Go ahead, sister.
I have two for the lesson and special requests God knows all about.
Amen. Anyone else?
Dear Lord, we're thankful today, dear God, for your many blessings. We lift up and magnify your name, dear Lord, because you alone are worthy to receive thanksgiving and honor and glory and praise, dear God, from your children. Father, we lift up and magnify you because you have written our names in the Lamb's Book of Life. We praise and magnify you, dear God, because you loved us first. We thank you, Lord, for sending your Son, Jesus, to die upon the cross. To be the propitiation for our sins, dear God, we thank you and praise you that you have saved us tonight. Now, Lord, we ask that you would intervene on behalf of each of the requests known, dear God, made known tonight, dear God, either by an uplifted hand signifying, dear God, a special unspoken request or those that were spoken. Lord, we ask that you would touch Brother David's wife, bring about healing and recovery to her arm through the injury, dear God, that your name is glorified. to the answer of this prayer. Father, we ask that you would meet the need that Sister Virginia has brought before us tonight, dear Lord, and the others, dear Lord, that were spoken out. You know what our needs are, dear God. Even before we do, we praise and magnify you, dear God, because of the answer of those prayers. We thank you, Lord, that you are sending those prayers, those answers, and the needs in the blessed and holy and righteous name of Jesus. We thank you and pray. Amen.
If everybody would please stand, we're going to read 1 John 4 and 7 together. And it says,
Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that loveth is born of God, and knoweth God.
Why don't you show some of that love right now as we sing this next song? Amen.
my heart's still fixed on Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
So what time is it?
It's offering time!
I even heard you sing.
Praise the Lord.
Oh, we thank you, God, that you keep the windows of heaven open up for the hanging of hope. People, we say why and how, but we know it's you, Jesus, that keeps everything going. And they keep coming in. The Lord let them stay in when they come in. Let them get that anointing that they need. We ain't trying to steal nobody, but Lord, if they're supposed to be here, like me, we're going to get stuck and stay wrapped up with Jesus. So God, we thank you, Lord, for this powerful, overflowing blessing in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Sorry. Here we go.
Time. Give us the wrong words.
that different music. So we're just going to hope this don't work. Hope it don't mess up again.
Thank you. Glory.
Bless your name, God.
Glory.
Bless your name, God.
Glory.
pray you'll be able to keep up with me in your Bibles tonight, but if you wouldn't mind standing, I'm going to read a few passages.
Glory,
glory, hallelujah, since I laid my burden down, I am feeling so much better since I laid my burdens down.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
We might have to sing that at the altar. I'm going to read from 1 Samuel 12 and 10. And they cried unto the Lord and said, we have sinned because we have forsaken the Lord and have served Balaam and Ashtaroth. But now deliver us out of the hand of our enemies and we will serve thee.
Amen.
Psalm 18 and 6 says, in my distress I called upon the Lord and cried unto my God. And he heard my voice out of his temple. And my cry came before him, even unto his ears. Psalm 120 and 1 says, in my distress I cried unto the Lord, and he heard me. Psalm 130 and 1 says, out of the depths I have cried unto thee, O Lord. Psalm 142 and 1, I cried unto the Lord with my voice. With my voice unto the Lord did I make my supplication. Hallelujah. Psalm 142 and 5. I cried unto thee, O Lord. I said, thou art my refuge and my portion in the land of the living. Hallelujah. Woo! Jonah 2 and 2 says, and said, I cried by reason of my affliction unto the Lord, and he heard me. Out of the belly of hell I cried, and thou heardst my voice. Hallelujah. Somebody praise him in the house. Somebody praise him in the house. He fell on the floor. Somebody had cried out to God, and God said he knew he was going to be in the service. And he said, I want you to know, you cry out to me, and I will hear your voice. You don't go short on the Lord. Facing horrific turmoil. You might be facing terrible trials. You might be facing insurmountable odds in your life, in your health, in your marriage, in your job, at your house. You might be facing terrible, terrible times. But my word just got through telling me 8 times I cried unto the Lord and he heard me in my distress. Today I was sitting at lunch and the Holy Ghost fell on me. We was at the dinner table at Brother Ricky's house enjoying a fine meal.
Glory to God.
And the Holy Ghost settled over me and they were carrying on conversations around the table and I couldn't hear nothing they were saying because I was supposed to be listening to them. The Holy Ghost was talking to the fat man. Between there and my house, I got 3 messages.
Glory.
said to me, he said, you know what I do. You know what I do. When you got two or three messages and you can't decide which one it's supposed to be, it ain't going to be none of them. The Holy Ghost is moving in this place. And more than one of you walked in this house tonight looking like a crippled man at the gate, beautiful, lifting up his cup to Peter and John, expecting to receive. You walked in this place tonight holding up your cup, expecting to receive. He told Shanda, you're on a book. I see the fire of the Holy Ghost engulfing and covering you.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Well,
God for two salvations, two more names.
Yes. Yes.
Anybody else got a testimony? testify, then I wanted to make sure everybody else got a chance first. I deal with so much that I don't tell anybody about. The devil fights me, and he comes after me, and he uses all kinds of things. In fact, I may not have come from the same kind of place that some people do. I may not have faced the same kind of battles that other people have faced. I may have come from a Christian home, a ministerial home. But the devil still comes after me.
Praise God.
And I praise God that he has called me.
Yeah.
I praise God that he has brought me to this church. Yeah. I praise God that he has given me a congregation and a family that makes me remember every ounce of power of God. Every time I step into the earth, every time I feel weak, I feel God and you behind me. And I know that God is in this place day in and day out. And I thank God.
Yes!
good.
All right. If no one else has any testimonies, I'd like to go through the one thing that we've promised to do at every service. Whether you're here with us or you're on live stream, we always go through this prayer because I never want to go through a service. Not in here, not with the children. But we don't give you an opportunity to find salvation.
Amen.
And we're going to show you the easiest way I know how. With me, I'll just put your thumb down. I said, Dear Lord, I'm a sinner.
Dear Lord, I'm a sinner.
Jesus, I know you're the Son of God. I know you died on the cross for my sins. And you were raised again on the third day. Come into my heart and forgive me, Jesus. You to look at your hand. Because a while ago, you just had your hand lifted. But now that you've said that prayer, you're holding on to the hand of God.
Yes.
You are walking with Him. You are breathing and living with Him. You are in His presence and by His side day in and day out. And I don't want you to ever forget that.
Amen.
If everyone would bow their heads, I'm going to pray over the close of the service. Dear Lord, we thank you so much for allowing us to be in the house tonight. You divined this night for a reason. You knew what we needed, and you delivered it right on time. Now, God, I ask you to be with us as we leave. Keep everyone under the sound of my voice safe, protected, and at peace until we can come together again. In your name, we thank you and we praise you. Amen.
Amen.